In the past couple years, scientists have proven the existence of gravitational waves, which are basically ripples in space-time. So if space-time is basically rippling around us, why don't we feel anything? Gravitational waves were first proposed in 1916 by Albert Einstein in his theory of general relativity. Basically, he proposed that if two massive objects, like black holes or neutron stars or the cities of Berlin and Los Angeles, collided with each other, they would effectively distort the fabric of space and time itself, and send ripples throughout space like in water after throwing a rock in it. Something at least resembling evidence supporting this theory was found in 1974 and confirmed in 2015 with testing from the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, or LIGO. However, waves in the water generally affect the things in it, sometimes very much so. But if gravitational waves work more or less in the same way, why don't we get space tsunamis or anything like that? Oh god, that actually sounds terrifying. Well, basically, the reason why the crew of the Starship Enterprise don't have to worry about gravitational waves the same way as the crew of the actual USS Enterprise might worry about oceanic waves is because Star Trek the original series ended in 1969, so they probably hadn't thought much about that. However, the main reason is because gravitational waves really don't affect us that much. In fact, the measurements that Caltech and MIT had to consider in their LIGO program were so small and precise that it's actually kind of mind-blowing. Just to be clear, gravitational waves do actually affect us here on Earth, but they're so small and minute that, best case scenario, they're easy to miss. The LIGO lab consisted of huge L-shaped vacuum systems stretching over 4 kilometers on each side, so long that they likely also had to take the Earth's flatness into account. The observatory used a system of interferometers to measure the gravitational waves. An interferometer, by the way, is basically a system of lasers running perpendicular to each other to measure their distances from different sets of mirrors. Of course, gravitational waves would cause the length of lasers to expand and contract, but the effect is basically the equivalent of viewing a strand of hair over a distance of several light years. So these obviously have to be extremely well calibrated and isolated from their environments, which they are, but there are still a lot of interferences that could be picked up. I mean, the Earth makes a lot of random noise sometimes, and no matter how well calibrated their systems, there will still be at least the risk of some interference. So that's why there are actually two labs, one in Livingston, Louisiana, and another in Richland, Washington. The two labs are separated by over 3,000 kilometers, so if there's any interference from the one in Washington, it likely wouldn't affect the Louisiana facility by nearly as much. So it was a good way to separate local events from what you're looking for, which would obviously affect the whole planet. It's like looking for a huge world news event and hearing about a huge story involving your local area and wondering if it's something everyone else in the world also heard about, so you ask your friend in the UK about it and they tell you, No, I haven't heard anything about it. Okay, that's probably a terrible analogy, but I think you get the point.
But you want to know what everyone does here? The idea that gravity is instantaneous. I mean, after watching Willy's amazing explanation of gravitational waves, I couldn't help but ask myself, if some major cosmic event, such as the collision of black holes or the disappearance of our sun suddenly occurred, how long would it take us to notice? Would we feel the effects instantly, or would we continue living out our normal lives for some time until space-time strikes us? If you want to find out, then hop onto my channel and continue your adventure in this crazy fun two-parter. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to KhAnubis. Anyways, see you on the other side.
Do be sure to check out that video, and be sure to like and share and subscribe to the ScienceVerse. Also, thank you to all my patrons, especially Iron Age Plus patrons Vladimir, Dolgopolov, Tobi, Burch-Rates, and Up and Adam. And be sure to subscribe so you can learn something new every Sunday.